actually demons that took the form of animals to help them with their magic. So traditionally, these could be really any type of animal, but some common ones were like cats, dogs, toads, rats. Yeah. And then they would always have a name, so they had some funny names like Sack and Sugar. Higgins.
Black Phillip.
Black Phillip. What's the other one? Vinegar Tom. I like that one.
Vinegar Tom.
This is a pop that I made for our Bump in the Night program.
Yeah.
So we did little skits. Well, they're supposed to be scary skits, and it was kind of a nighttime tour through the site. And my husband actually volunteered to play my... My real husband volunteered to play my pretend husband, and that was his voodoo doll.
I was going to ask if...
Yes, yeah, so if I pretended to break his leg. Well, when they get to Virginia, this is what they were carved out of for a long time.
No kidding, so even back then they were carving jack-o'-lanterns.
Oh, before they come to the New World, they're carving jack-o'-lanterns.
Do you know the history of that?
Sort of, yeah. It comes from, there's a myth, I don't know if you really call it a myth or a folktale, about Jack O' the Lantern. And it's a guy who, there's a story, there's a couple different variations of the story, but basically he was a guy who was not very good in his life, and I think he makes a deal or a bet with the devil. And he wins the bet. Oh, yes. So he makes a bet, and he wins. And therefore, the devil doesn't take him to hell. Because he knew he had a bad life. And so he says, all right, if I win, you don't get to take me to hell. And so the devil says, okay. So he wins, doesn't get to go to hell. But when he dies, heaven doesn't accept him either because he's had such a bad life. So he's forced to just kind of wander the earth. And he was said to have taken up residence in a hollowed out gourd as his home, and that is Jack O' the Lantern.